This will not take long.
Send
for your own.
Oh, no. What have you done?
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye. That we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet. But they will. Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
Ayawas ne yate hagum sere, andahyayum eskanas is agum haja.
Thank you.
do this?
To protect Adams and Hancock and those they serve. You meant to kill them.
Kill them? Are you mad? I wanted only to parley. There was so much to discuss, to explain. You've put an end to that now.
If you speak true, then I will carry your last words to them.
They must lay down their arms. They must stop this war.
Why them and not the Redcoats?
Do you not think we ask the same question of the British? These things take time. And it would have succeeded had you let me play my part.
Part of the puppeteer.
Who better we hold the strings than another?
No, the strings should be severed. All should be free.
And we should live forever on castles in the sky. You wield your blade like a man, but your mouth like a child. And more will die now because of that.
Sahan yönerin ne oteen am da settakwe. Tini on ne jaho teen at am da settakwe.
Like that. Why don't you just go out there and just help this camp retreat? Don't ever do that again, you hear me? God damn it!
General Putnam.
You live.
The same cannot be said for Pitcairn.
Well done, I suppose. But it matters little now. I'm ordering a full retreat. We have lost too many in exchange for too little. If the Tories want this hill so badly, let them have it. Boston's the true prize.
We have a bigger problem.
What do you mean? This can't be right. It says they plan to murder Washington.
should make sure the village is safe.
Mierda.
Radun hagedun za shewe nekti ohnu jera wa kanu tunyu hue do got ti go oya rungwe ayezene sege
unka giga oya rungwe
de ohne gujes Charles Lee luana tupa yasago ya tohawe kana dogu dano do kara ni hadi
na hoda ka numo ni honenu
wa de sago di dashtana tini hadi ayun ki unta
Ya te tkari hua yeri.
Ona dera di deza ni kuhare. Ya kon tak deza duhuntani ne giga, ne aya guaderio.
Ona ti as chaga ne, te tom tohu ta ketasta.
Gedum, the boss is done.
Nahoda?
Gwegum wa glory near Charles Lee. But triot the hona donzonia yung kiat one for. Don't go easy, I say, you know what is it?
A toga tigarungwe.
Honru zip is out nigura denu. Zia sade nyanda the squat nigura gani. Nick the owner gone runete. Zinguan hugarum de.
They got your scar, gigo.
Connecting what your scars, you what gonya has in a square, the new statsege. Don't use that nigura di hunto. Then what does want ducks out there? Nezungwe da summa!
Zadarissa!
Unka Dorissa, no nazahe yum.
Я Атена, та ти за танцем, цика до Гетстане. Родонагедум, Чарльз Лі, Маунтмет, Уаса Таджип. Асагонарду Масе, цина холдом патріот, Родонадену Юні. Джуран Сага, Асагонасе те. Он докта гіга модерію. Родонадіо хохот гвеню. Unge nungue da summa. Oh, die hat dann am Start unge.
Iwe re ya na wandu ta ingwa ya da no Start unge. Ona wa sadresa yung jataro.
Ammunition, sir, and the enemy advances.
Then we need to pull back, rejoin the others, and cover their escape.
Get to the
care of this!
Well done, my friend. You have saved many lives today.
Connor?
Charles Lee has betrayed you. He forced retreat in the midst of battle, hoping the lost would take the lives of your men and see you relieved of your command.
What?
I'm sure he will come and spin a tale saying that he was outnumbered or I was somehow to blame. All lies. I will say it one last time. That man is your enemy, and he will not stop until you are dead or dishonored.
Connor's tale rings true. Lee was acting most odd upon the battlefield.
I will investigate these allegations at once.
The time for that is long past.
This must be done properly, else we're no better than those we oppose. Never mind the political ramifications of such an act.
Should you choose to spare Lee's life, then I will take it myself. Enjoy your victory, Commander. It will be the last I deliver you.
Not so fast, Mr. Miles, in case you hadn't noticed.
I'd get the power source hooked up before heading back into the Animus.
but it's your call.
Come. Come now. Your sadness won't sustain me any more than that fool woman's soups and potions. Tell me of your latest exploits.
Charles Lee has been exposed, and the Patriots finally rid of him. They march now to secure the remaining cities that this country might finally be free.
Then you have won. The land and your people are safe. Yet you seem troubled.
Washington spared Lee's life.
So long as he lives, all are in danger. The same is true for your father. When you first came to me, you understood what had to be done, swore you'd see it through. If not for the Brotherhood, for your people, and all those threatened by the Templars.
But with Lee gone, my father might...
Listen to me. You have not come this far to throw it all away over misplaced sentiment. Both men must die.
Achilles.
There is nothing more to discuss.
Connor, I came as soon as I could.
Tell me you bring good news.
The Comte de Grasse said yes. You need only join his fleet in Chesapeake Bay and they will serve as required. But what exactly is it you intend?
It's better that I show you.
Enemy approaching! All right, boys! Make ready for war! Looks like they're coming to sail out! Ready for
back here! Are you stupid? Come back!
He's running, Lafayette. Yep, rabbit. Lads, he's run! Are you run off?
Damn it! We're the ones who did the killing out here! Any witnesses?
sorry to have disappointed.
As you should be. For us to have come all this way for nothing. Tell me now why I shouldn't have you thrown into the sea.
No need to be rash. Only give me a little more time. I'll scour the other ships if I must. I'm certain there are prisoners who will meet your needs.
Very well. You have 2 days.
Thank you.
Present yourself to the Green Dragon Tavern in Boston with the men you've chosen. We shall meet you there along with our master.
Wasted.
Stop that! Don't make me call the guards!
Make a sound and you die.
What do you want? He's in the harbor, at the Long Pier, most likely. We heard what happened at the parade. Charles got all nervous, said he was leaving the country. I thought he was overreacting. It's not. No!
Thank you.
Oh.
Ay, corre, Connor.
Afuera.
Put us down, we rise again. You end one plot, we forge another. You try so hard, but it always ends the same. Those who know you think you mad, and this is why. Even those men you sought to save have turned their backs on you. Yet you fight. You resist. Why?
Because no one else will.
Fucking hero.
Rough night, was it?
He headed inland, took a ferry up the Charles River.
I will need passage as well.
Of course. Only say the word.
Why would they leave this behind?
Long have we waited for you to return. You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone, chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it, where none shall think to look. And then in time, what once was shall be. Again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place, as was your people's purpose, and that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
I know where the key is.
Then let's go!
Time to see what's inside.
Not quite. We still need to get the place powered up.
Find the remaining pedestals and plug in the power sources.
I'm on it.
Hey Desmond, didn't Subject 16's...
His name was Clay.
Sorry, didn't Clay say Washington was a Templar?
No. He indicated that Washington came into contact with an Apple of Eden, but beyond that, it's all speculation. Furthermore, judging from the portrait referenced by Clay, the event occurred much later in Washington's life. Perhaps Connor wasn't even involved. It's very hard to know for sure. We'll just have to wait and see what, if anything, happens.
Hello. Hey. Do you think killing
I regret not asking you to hack into the Abstergo servers while you were there. A couple of well-placed relays and we'd be swimming in information.
We have everything we need.
Yeah, except the key.
We're close.
How do you know?
I just do.
I poke a bit. Do you know Dean's here that...
Killing Setterback?
I doubt. Sure, he cleared the end. They've had knowledge decades. None of even place. I once made death. At least he was more simple than I said. I'm sorry, Don Smith did. Trying to tell.
Hey, subjects to...
Namely.
Didn't Clay, Washington's tub...
Detective Washington to connect with Olivia beyond the speculation. Furthermore, it's not very right. The event, much less what she liked. That's not even involved. It's very hard to know for sure. Anything.
If we could not meet the sun's cruel embrace, perhaps we might rebuke it. Already we could generate the fields to protect us in times of strife. But these were small and simple things. To replicate them on a scale the size of a world, we lack the energy to make it so. Half the world, they said then. It is better than none at all. We tried. Again, we failed. A quarter, they asked. Even this we could not do. A sixth, an eighth, a tenth, they cried. The answer was still the same. Perhaps in time a city might be spared. But it was time we did not have. So we moved on.
Wonder what's inside.
Only one way to find out.
Existence and only awaiting discovery? Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat in thrall and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What we imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolved to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent a dozen of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control, to direct the beam. To enthrall the world. To speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Back to change the past, but we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward. And so here we sought to see beyond ourselves and know what was to come. First we watched to learn if our work would succeed. But the answer was always the same. So we moved on to other things. But she remained. The one you call Minerva. In time, she too stopped looking, and instead began to speak. She called out across time, in the hopes that you might be saved. She hid messages where none might find them, save for you and those within this place.
Fascinating.
Tired of it. The cryptic warnings, the threats. Just tell us what you want!
But they are. We saw the Nephilim there. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Imagine trying to explain all this to a 2-year-old, to a grasshopper. When they said the will of the gods was unknowable, they meant it. Literally.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to.
Desmond.
Lucy was going to betray us and take the apple back to Abstergo. I saw the satellite launched. I saw them turn it on, and then it failed. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful.
I'm telling you, there's something down here.
Don't be daft.
I don't know, maybe they were sleeping or something and we woke them. Some kind of cryogenics? Or hibernation? I mean, how do we know what the hell they were doing down here?
They were working on a bunch of different solutions, but nothing worked. Just went from one to the next, and then, I don't know. They must have left at some point. After the end.
I wonder what the world would be like if they'd succeeded.
I'm more concerned about what it'll be like if we don't.
Salvation. They found a way. Too late for them, but not for you. Sealed to protect it. Though now it bars your way Find the key. The past will tell. Consume us, for we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice, not to save us all. So we sought to change what we were. In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita. My husband. My love. In the end, it changed him. Ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive, but his mind became brittle to the touch. He begged me for release. For days. For weeks. For months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us. Electrical impulses, and the body a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles to dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced with something stronger, something better? So we forged a new vessel, one that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered. Were they right to turn away? Thank you.
We're almost there, son. We'll have plenty of time to talk when this is all over. We should focus on our work now.
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Moment of truth.
You know our story now, of how we tried, of how we failed, all our hopes extinguished, save one, your touch, a spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal!
Minerva?
You! But how? You left! You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machine to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place. And finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying! Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved.
Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world. Merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better? She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't!
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and to die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us! We'll find another way.
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
Some sort of global aurora borealis. Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now recording seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... on record. Satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's event. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... now it's time that I play mine.
We'll be right back.
plug.
Thank you.
If you're hungry, have extra.
No, thank you. Where is everyone?
They're gone west. Been a while since they left. Seems some fella from New York was granted the land by Congress.
What?
Seeing it happen more and more. Government says they don't take land that's already owned, but...
How could this have happened?
We're on our own now. No more merry English parts and labour. Which means we gotta go at it ourselves. Gotta pay for it too. Selling land is quick and easy, not quite so nasty as taxes. And since some say they're what started the old war, ain't no rush to bring 'em back. Clever men, these new leaders of ours. They know not to push it just yet. Too soon for taxes. Too British. Be safe.
All right, we're up and running.
This code is hacked to all hell. Nicely hacked, but hacked. The worm found 3 pivots before failing, so we've got those. You need to locate the remaining pivots on your own from inside. The 3 we've got will triangulate the rest. It's a sweet bit of hacking on my part, if I dare say. Each pivot detects the others in proximity. There should be 12 total. Everyone you find is supposed to produce a hex cipher, and that's what we're after. Once you find them all, we'll sequence the code, package the data, and Bob's your uncle. Now don't putz around too much in revolutionary America. I know it's tempting. So I've planted 2 of our pivots, not easy from my end, believe you me, but there they are. You can see those 2 activating a buried one, kinda. If you drop the 3rd one we have, the buried pivot's precise location should resolve. Then go gather the hex cipher, rinse, and repeat. If you get a chance, I'd love to see Franklin's glass harmonica in person. Just a side note. Have fun.
Go play somewhere else. Go!